What's up, guys? It's Hedge. Do you guys remember this place? It has been so long, and I actually started recording an episode for this right after I finished my 100 subscriber special. And turned out my microphone was muted for that. Let me make sure. Nope. Okay, good. Mine's not muted now. So I had to discard that content because, well, I didn't do much anyways on it. I just kind of talked about how the 100 subscriber special went. I think I'll do a little bit of that now, but not as much in detail since it's been a while since that's been put up. Basically, I went in there fully geared, with fully enchanted armor of all types, like boots, leggings, helmet, chest plate, diamond, everything. And then I diamonds used a diamond sword, and I enchanted that, and I enchanted a bow, and all this stuff. And then I would go right in there, and I build a little nether rack bridge over to the main island. And boom! Dragon comes and knocks me off. All that stuff to waste. Before I had put a single shot on a tower or anything, it was just all gone. So that was really frustrating. I had to come back here. I did my best with this. I have regular iron and a diamond chest plate. I actually probably won't wear this the whole episode. You know, me and armor, it seemed like such a waste. I mean, count the diamonds, it makes that up. I lost a full suit of that. So, and it was unused, perfect condition. So I was pretty pissed off. Yeah, and then it went okay from there, I guess you could say. Kind of how I expected, kind of long, kind of boring. That's why I made it into that little montage, speed clip, whatever you want to call it. Because if you had to sit through that whole thing, you'd be bored out of your minds. And it also was a good subscriber special. So, here's what I started to do in the last episode, or the episode that I tried to record, but it was muted, is I started to work on this thing again. And it has been so long since we've recorded this. And I actually have a good song for you guys today, because I think I'm going to do a speed build again. I have a good song for you guys today. It's been a while since I've done a speed build. The song is called, oh, I don't remember what it's called. I think it's called Beside Me? No. Look in the description for the song title. Actually, one of my friends made this song. He goes to college, I think Cal, I'm not really sure. I don't know him that well, but I know him through my church, and he and my other friend, the vocalist in the song, she helped them record this song, and I think it was turned out pretty good. So I asked him if I could use it in this video, or in my Minecraft videos, whatever you want to call it, YouTube. And he said, "Yeah, sure, go ahead." So his name is Cameron Corello, I believe that's how you pronounce it. Again, I don't know him that well. I just know him through one of the churches I go to. So yeah, he's pretty cool guy though, for the little bit that I've known him, and his music is pretty good. He's definitely not that big yet, but he's going to some school for electronic music, so I think he's definitely going to be up and coming. If he sticks to what he's doing, he's going to have a really good career ahead of him. So I'm excited for him, and I'm excited to use his music as well. So please go check him out. I think I'll put a link right here on the screen for you, lazy people. If you don't want to go to the description, and that will lead you to his SoundCloud page. So go check that out. So anyways, I'm going to get started here. And I mean, I don't know how much I can do, but I'll see what I can do. I may go in the middle of this recording and go collect more glowstone and netherrack, because those are the two things I don't have enough of right now. All right, so let's get started. Okay, so I've gotten a good ways here. I'm kind of, well, I'm gonna go to bed here anyways. It's only 9 o'clock here, but still, not really feeling, I'm feeling kind of tired from the day. Big weekend again, so probably gonna go to bed here, but, I think I'll be done working on this, for the episode, and I'll come back in the next one, because that was a lot of work right there. Burn. That's right. I've got fire aspect one, baby. So I think I'm done for this episode on this part. I'm gonna come back later. I'm not really sure what I'm gonna work on for the rest of the episode, but I'll sleep on it. Whoa, that was my knuckle cracking. I'll sleep on it, and then, I'll get back to you guys. Alright guys, so I wandered off here a bit. I was looking around. Our base is that way. Probably see it in a second, actually. We're not too far away. But I've been debating. Well, first off, let me tell you this. This is the new snapshot. I'm not sure what week it is. Maybe 41. But it's a new snapshot. And you can kind of see. Ooh, you can see some caves there. They're unlit. That's not good. And the mob system going down. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. So this is the new snapshot right here. Whoa, that is the first time I've ever seen this on camera. I might have to edit that out. But speaking of editing, actually, I recently got Adobe After Effects, which is definitely a step up from what I have. But not only is it a step up in, like, you know, performance and capabilities. But it's a little bit harder to work with. It's a little bit more advanced. It's a little bit more intricate and less basic. So I'm going to try to edit this in that, but if it takes too long, then I'm going to go back to my old editor, which I have still on my computer. If this video comes out a little late, that is why. If you guys have any experience with it that you'd... dog is barking. That doesn't usually happen on camera either. It's a weird day today. If you guys have any experience, any tips or anything, or you want to, like, guide me through doing some stuff on it, I'd be up for that. I think you can personal message me. My Skype isn't on my page anymore, but it was at one point. Anyways, so I've been debating whether to spend my time... I'm going to show you something. Whether to spend my time trying to get carrots and potatoes. Because I want to build carrot and potato farms down in there. So I started doing that. And I was trying to get zombies. Because I heard that zombies drop them as a rare drop. But apparently with the new snapshot, creepers can explode in my system. And it happened once already. And then when it happened the second time... I just rage quit and gave up on it. So, I think I'm going to wait, actually, till the next snapshot to see if it gets fixed. Because if it doesn't, then I got to think of a different design for this. I still haven't made a spider farm. I might do that in the future, probably. But since I was having trouble getting potatoes and carrots, the second option I had for today was an iron golem farm. Because if you haven't been... checking your snapshot information. Then in this snapshot and the future ones, there's these things called I don't know, but they I forget what they're called. Oh, anvils. They're called anvils, and basically you make them out of a ton of iron. It's like 6 iron blocks and an iron ingot, so it's really heavy on the iron. And they also deteriorate, so basically what they do is they repair your weapons, but keep the enchants, in the simplest reason. And it takes experience to do that, as well as enchanting. And then you can also, like, custom name them and stuff, like your tools and stuff. But yeah, that's the gist of it. So basically, right now there's a bug where you can keep it in good, like it won't deteriorate, it won't wear down, but that's gonna be fixed. So I'm gonna have to think about getting a more steady supply of iron, which should also be cool for armor because right now I have enough, but it's gonna run out if I don't go mining, and I don't really want to go mining, so I'm probably gonna make an iron golem farm. Now, on the screen there will be a little link to Doc M's video, given that I can figure out how to do it with Adobe. But you need villagers for this, and I was planning on making it. This is the house that I never finished, by the way. Remember over by the villager place? Look at all those pumpkins, man. The village is that way somewhere. And all the villagers should be down here. So, you need villagers, obviously, two at the minimum, if you're going to make an iron golem farm. Two to start. Let's see if there's any in here. So you need two to start. But as of right now, I don't have any villagers near my base, my main base. So, if I was to make it, I'd either have to ship them over there, or just over here. Build it over here. But I kind of want to keep this place like this because I don't see why we should change it. But what I'm gonna do right now is figure out how to get some villagers. Might be as simple as putting a block right here, but I need to get some villagers to escape so that they will so I can see if I can get them through the Nether portal. Actually, let me head into creative real quick, and then we're gonna test if I can get them through the portal, because I don't want to have to go through the trouble and then find out it doesn't work. So I'll be right back. All right, so this obviously isn't super flat, but I'm going to make a new super flop flat super flop super flat world. I'm gonna keep the old one just because I have a lot of stuff on it, but this is gonna be the new one because there are world options for this. You can customize super flat
All right,
worlds
so I
now.
could not for the life of me figure out what to do for this. So I couldn't figure out how to do a slab. I think it was s because all the slabs were the same. So what I'm gonna do instead is mycelium, I think. Let's see if this works. Yeah, it did. Okay. So mycelium is now going to be the top. This should work. So let's see how this generates. The reason I wanted to do that was so that, oh, frame lag. It was so, whoa, that looks really interesting. All right, I'm not sure if I like this or not, but the reason I did it was so slimes won't spawn when I'm trying to build stuff, because that can be really annoying. I could have also gone for stairs, possibly. I might take a little bit more time just to double check that I can't use slabs, because I would rather have slabs than this, to be honest. It's kind of an ugly color, but yeah. Oh, look, this is going to be a village, I bet. All right, perfect. Nice. So I can test the villager thing now. Let's go ahead and do it. This actually looks pretty cool with the sandstone along the mycelium, which is purple. Don't really mind that. Okay, so let's get to work. Let's find, first of all, obsidian, and we need a flint and steel. I'm not gonna make anything fancy for this. All right, and let's get some. This is the anvil. So you see, it goes from very damaged, slightly damaged, really damaged, and then it will break unless you take a very damaged one and you break the block under it, because then it will fall and it'll be fine. Now, when you right-click on it, it shows how you can add things like this. So that's what we're gonna try to achieve. I'm noticing that that might be a problem, but hopefully not. All right, so let's build a little portal right here. Two, three, up and down like this. All right, now we just need someone to, oh, made a cool sound. Nice. All right, so buddy, you're gonna go in there, all right? Well, we might have to generate it ourselves. Oh, does it work in super? It does work in super flat. Okay, good. You go through it really quickly too. You don't have to wait for it to spin. That's kind of weird. All right, where is? Oh my. Okay, they're all invisible. Okay, screw that. We're gonna make a bunch of them. Oh yeah. All right. Let's just let's do this fancy way. Let's get some sandstone, which I really do like the color of. I like sandstone. The purple looks good with it too. All right, get out of my way. All right, so let's spawn a guy in here. Now go through. No, not myself. I'm going through rather quickly, I feel like. All right, bud, can you please go in? It's the only way to go. Only way. Just do it, man. Just do it. Not me. You. You, sir. I'm gonna look like an idiot if this doesn't work. Alright, I need piston and a lever. Let's go. This guy's going in. Whether he likes it or not. Alright, so he's right here. Boom. Boom. Get ready, man. Get ready. Yes. It has worked. Where is he? He was here. He was here. How would he? Did he go to the? Oh, he's in the ground. Okay. I think it worked though. We gotta try again just to be sure. That's cool how you go so fast. Kind of cool. Alright, let's try this again. Let's go in here first, though. Oh! He was right there. Alright. Break away this so that when he does come, he'll fall right into our trap. Alright. Yeah, you go through that thing instantly. Alright. Here you go, bud. Oh, fall. I think it's working though. Now I might have to do it on a mass scale to get proof, but let's see if I can do that. Alright. Just load it up. What if this glitch? Oh yep, that's still in the game. Alright. Start going through. Go. 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 Don't break anything. Yes! Alright, they are officially in the nether. As far as I'm concerned. Yep, I can hit them. They seem to be here. So that is amazing. Alright. Let us go back into our survival world. And let's get this guy out of here. Because he needs to come with us. Alright, this is going to take some time, I think, so I'm going to have to skip this and come back when I'm done fooling around with these guys. Maybe I'll finish this house someday. Maybe not. Alright, so that was actually a lot easier than I thought. Really, all you had to do was get them lined up to here, so if you have the same design, all you got to do is get them lined up to here and then, like, lined up with the water and then just punch them once and they'll float up right to the top. So these two cuties are right in here. Oh, this guy's already getting on land. What a good boy. This guy, he's working. He's getting there. Let's give him a little push, shall we? Come on. Oh, you fell back down. Darn. See what I mean? Oh. That time he didn't go up. Oh, I think he's not in line. Okay. The other side, and I barely have enough villagers to do this at this point because there we go. Because he, no, don't sink again, don't sink. Oh, no, this guy's gonna try to escape. That is not cool. Oh, now this guy's gonna try. Okay, you stay there. Oh, wait, I gotta make sure he doesn't. Oh, dang it, I gotta make sure he doesn't Go back. Nope, stay. 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 Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Nope. Yes. Now I just gotta get out. Darn. Nope, I'm hitting him. Dang it. Oh, so frustrating. Oh, that's an awful deal. No. No, I'm not doing that. Not today. Okay. This is not good. What do I do? How do I... I'm too close to you. Okay, you go to that corner, I'll go to this one. Ready? Dang it! Hurting him. Don't want to hurt you. I need an enderpearl really bad right now. Really bad. I can't do anything. Okay. Time for a super pick. I don't want to hurt him with this, though, because that would hurt him badly. Okay, ready? The guy's getting away. Alright. Oh, so close. Yes. Ninja Pro. Alright, where did that guy go? Did you fall in my trap? That would be amazing. Nope. Ah. Hey there, bud. Stay right there. No need to worry. Beautiful. Alright, this is my my dirt wall. Yeah, I think I will finish this house. It's a nice house, I guess. I gotta go get my supplies, though. Well, yeah, I think I will. I'll get tracks set up to get him here. Actually, before we do that, they're safe now. So there you can see the village, the trees over there. They're safe right now. Actually, let's go see if there's any backup villagers at the village over here. I think one of the reasons why they don't spawn that many in there is because they're spawning in the village, and it's still considering that part as a village. So that may be the problem. Maybe not, but it's my theory. Let's go check this out. It's been a while since we've been over here. We only really came over once to get those two guys. Alright, so... yeah, this is the mess that I made. Okay, yeah, we got a couple of guys in here. Three guys in here. Whoa. Whoa. You got a mess. Whoa, this is kind of cool. Like... alright, I can do this. Oh, never mind. I thought that was, like, out to the open. Pretty standard. I never checked to see if there's a blacksmith, but I don't think there is. Unfortunately, this house is kind of retarded, kind of stuck in the ground. Anyways, there's a desert over there. Oh, that's right. Another reason I came over here was for emeralds, but you don't really need emeralds as much as you would want the ores, because you can trade all you want. Alright, so how do I get back home? Whoa. Is it this way? It's gotta be this way. I would have made it over. Yeah, I would have made it over by the... I think I would have made it over by the mountains. Let's hope. Yeah, this is going to be it. I see light. Yeah, that's right. I made it right on the side of the mountain. Alright. So, let's go back home and make some preparations for these guys. We actually don't need them until we build the entire thing, I think. I'm going to go review Dokkem's tutorial, which will be in the description. I want to see... I've got... ooh, nice. Didn't know this was all over here. Glass and all. I kind of left this project abruptly. How about next episode we do this? We'll finish putting a roof on, get a little workstation set up, be nice and dandy. Steak. Man. Richer than I thought. Alright, so I'll be back in a little bit. I'm going to go review that tutorial to make sure, or to see, I don't know why I took damage, to see what I got to do to prepare. Alright, it's definitely time for an update. So, here's what I've done. First of all, I've watched through the entire tutorial, again, while I was doing this. So I definitely think this will work for, actually, I downloaded Dokkem's old map, and I tried it out in the new update, and it definitely works. So, I am not worried about that anymore. So for this design that we're going to build, again, the link will be in the description for every episode that I build this, because it's not just going to be this episode. Actually, this episode might be over a little in a little bit, but this is just a temporary spawning. Spawning block for the villagers once I bring them over, because we need 8 villagers for each pad that we do. And thinking about doing his full 4, like 2 towers. Whoa, mouse going crazy. The 2 tower thing that he has in this tutorial. So it's going to be very large. Whoa, what's wrong with the mouse? I don't know. Anyways, so down here, this is where I'm going to build it. I'm going to put it in this area. There's going to be pressure plates right here. Water pushing the items when they drop. Probably fill this out with iron bar. Oh, I might have to use glass blocks, actually, because, oops. I'm going to pretty all this up later, but I think glass blocks will be necessary because they can't have room to go anywhere. Like, these iron bars, you can kind of go halfway into the block, and that might stop the crusher from working. So, the glass blocks is going to be the way to go. So, yeah, this is where it's going to go, down in here. It's going to fit nicely there because, like you saw at the top, there's a nice open-ish area up there where we can build the towers. That's going to be very cool once we get going. So, yeah, I need to go get the villagers and then put the villagers into here so they start breeding. And then most likely what I'm going to do is just AFK over here. Oh, and I had to take out all the wooden doors here. Just kind of a bummer, but I want this to work well. So I had to take out all the doors over here so it wouldn't interfere with that iron golem farm. So, and my one up there too. I'm going to put an iron door instead. Alright, so I'm probably going to, let's go over there right now. All we need to do is get the 2 villagers that we have locked up. This makes a weird sound now. Hear that? It's like a clicking. Anyways, wow. Do I bother with it? I guess I do. There we go. Alright. No more. So let's go over here and get those guys. Okay, so I already recorded this once. And I another clip, but basically I got the villagers from way some direction. I don't even know. Transported them over to the Nether, which took forever because they did not want to cooperate with that Nether portal, man. But yeah, I've been sitting here for a while, and a lot of these have been breeding, and I actually got a golem to spawn right on top of this thing. So means we're doing pretty good with our iron golem farm. I already got 4 iron from it. So yeah, I think I'm gonna end the clip here though, because this is gonna be a long-term project. I'll probably work a lot in between this and the next episode on it. But yeah, it's gonna be a long-term project. Again, check DocM's video in the description if you haven't seen it already. Good stuff there. Genius, really. So over here, I'm gonna explain this a little bit. So there's the hole. I think I showed you this already. But that's where the iron golems are gonna fall. And over there, we're gonna come out a little bit this way before with piping, and then we're gonna go this way. I believe somewhere around 45 blocks, and then that way 45 blocks. And that'll be the center of our 2 towers, and they'll have one probably around right here going up, and then the other equal distance the other direction. So it is going to be sweet. Stay tuned, guys, because it's going to get pretty epic with this thing. And I actually do have a lot of iron, more than I thought I had, but this is still going to be sick because then we can build with a lot of iron blocks and look all rich and stuff. So, yeah.
I see lava through there. That would be nice for when we make this. We can use that lava up. So, anyways, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.